Welcome to our Beginning End of the Bomb Talk Story Series. My name is Jose Barzola from the Matsunaga Institute for Peace at the University of Hawaii at Manoa. Our talk story today will focus on Hiroshima Hibakusha. I will never forget that day with Ms. Kiyomi Kono. Thank you for joining us today to learn about resiliency during unprecedented time. Today's event will be live streamed on our community Facebook pages through the 150th Italian Veterans Education Center, aka Club 100, Conflict Resolution Alliance, Kitui Honolulu, and the Spark and Matsunaga Institute for Peace and Conflict Resolution. We thank you so much for joining us today. This event is co-sponsored by the Hiroshima Peace Memorial Museum, that is a museum located in Hiroshima Peace Memorial Park in central Hiroshima, Japan, dedicated to documenting the atomic bombing of Hiroshima in World War II. The museum was established in 1955 with the Hiroshima Peace Memorial Hall. Today's event will be on Hiroshima Hibakusha, atomic bomb survivor, Ms. Kiyomi Kono, who will provide a testimony of her exposure to the atomic bombing at Hiroshima City in August of 1945. Ms. Kiyomi Kono was born in 1931 in Asakita Ward, Hiroshima City, exposed to the atomic bombing when entering Hiroshima City as a second year student at girls' school on August 7, 1947, recorded her memories of the bombing in atomic bomb drawings by survivors and published a picture book, Watashi wa Wasurenai, I Will Never Forget That Day. Ms. Kono started giving atomic bomb survivor testimony to junior high school students from 2003, gave testimonies at universities in the state of Missouri in the United States in 2011 and in the states of Washington State, Oregon, and New Mexico in 2013. Also to assist us today with translation is Ms. Hitomi Sato from the Hiroshima Interpreter and Guide Association. And to get us started, I'm gonna turn it over to our special guest today, Ms. Kono-san. Thank you so much.
Hello, everyone. My name is Kiyomi Kono. I am 89 years old. Nice to meet you. 皆様、今年はコロナのパンデミックスで世界中大変なことになりました。
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now in the dire situation because of coronavirus pandemic all over the world.
放射能もウイルスも目には見えませんが、人間を破滅させる強い力を持っています。
Neither virus nor radiation released by the atomic bomb are visible.But both have the power to ruin human beings.
ウイルスの方は今ワクチンやそれから治療薬の開発でなんとか防げると思います。早く世界中が協力して助け合って収束してほしいと強く願っております。
However, regarding coronavirus, treatment drugs and the vaccines are now under development. So soon after, hopefully, there would be a solution. Now, I strongly hope that people from countries all over the world come together to contain the pandemic.
私は30年前一度ハワイにお邪魔したことがあります。ホノルル空港でプルメリアの霊をかけていただいたり、それからホテルの28階からワイキキのエメラルドブルーの海の色を眺めたり、それからダイヤモンドヘッドなどのことを今懐かしく思い出しております。
It was about 30 years ago, I firstly visited Hawaii. I still remember I received the lay of the plumeria. It was beautiful. And I still clearly remember the Waikiki beach, the emerald blue, wonderful color, and the diamond head. And soon after, I remember the Mount Kilauea was exploded.
でも何よりも衝撃を受けましたのは、真珠湾にあったアリゾナ記念館でした。
Above all, the biggest shock was the USS Arizona Memorial.
館内には多くの兵士が、屍がそのまま眠っていらっしゃると聞いて、体が震え、涙が止まりませんでした。
I heard that still many soldiers are lying inside the vessels, and I was shocked and I couldn't stop my tears.
誰が悪いんでもない。戦争が悪いんだと本当に戦争を憎みました。
Nobody was wrong, but it was war which killed many people. War was wrong.
戦争は人の命を奪うものだと本当に涙が止まりませんでした。
Thinking that I couldn't stop my tears at that time.
では今から75年前、ここ広島に原子爆弾が投下された時のお話をさせていただきます。
Then let me talk about the story 75 years ago、ね、when the atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima.
1945年8月6日、進みませんけどいいですか？午前8時15分、広島市に人類最初の原子爆弾が投下されました。
It was at 8:15 a.m. August 6th, 1945, when the first atomic bomb ever in human history was dropped here on Hiroshima by the United States.
爆弾は町のほぼ 中央にあります相生橋を目標に約1万メートル上空から投下され、地上600メートルで炸裂して広島市は焼けてしまいました。
The bomb fell from the B-29 about 10,000 meters above the targeted 相生 bridge and exploded 600 meters above the ground.
これは被爆した広島の地図です。原子爆弾が投下されて爆心地から半径2キロの地域は人も建物もみんな焼き尽くされました。
This shows the damages to the city of Hiroshima. Within the 2 km radius, human beings and buildings were all burned down.
私が生まれた頃、日本は今の中国と戦争を始めました。そして小学校の5年生になった時、今度は真珠湾の海軍基地を攻撃して、アメリカ、イギリス、フランスなど連合国とも戦争を始めました。
When I was born, Japan has just started Japan Sino War. When I became a fifth grader, Japan started the Pacific War with the Allied forces by attacking Pearl Harbor.
私の子供の頃は戦争ばっかり続いておりました。原子爆弾が落ちた時は爆心地より北へ30キロのところの田舎に住んでおりました。中学2年生でした。
In my childhood, war was always there. When the atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima, I was 14 years old. I lived in the countryside 30 kilometers away from the epicenter.
これは当時の家族の写真です。左から両親、祖母、弟、丸枠は東南アジアに戦争に行っていた兄です。
Please see this picture. The girl labeled Kiyomi is me and my family. From the left, my parents, my younger brother, and my grandma. The circled one is my elder brother. He was dispatched to the Southeast Asia as a soldier.
私の両側に住んでいる二人の姉が原子爆弾が落ちた時、広島に住んでおりました。スミコとミドリは広島に住んでおりました。
Two of my elder sisters beside me were living in Hiroshima City when the bomb was dropped.
2月7日、私は母と二人で姉を探しに焼け野原になった広島の町を一日中歩き回りました。
The next day, on August 7th, my mother and I went to Hiroshima City to search for my two sisters.
その時見た恐ろしい光景、いつまでたっても忘れることができません。
The horrible scenery I saw was really unforgettable for me to this day.
70歳の時、原爆と得る募集がありました。
When I turned 70 years old, a local broadcasting station called for survivors to draw their memories.
私は北の緑が勤めている病院の花壇に少年の死体が山積みされていたのを思い出して、それを絵に残そうと思いました。
Then I remembered that I was shocked by the bodies of the boys who were piled up like a timber on the flower bed of the hospital where we went to look for my second eldest sister. So I made up my mind to draw the scene from my memory.
でも絵を描いたことがないのでなかなか難しかったけど、一生懸命にこのような絵を描きました。
But it was very hard for me because I had never drawn a picture in earnest. Anyway, I did my best and I drew this picture.
この絵がモニュメントとして病院に置いていただきました。そのことがきっかけで、私はまた絵本を一冊変えて出版しました。
Eventually, this painting became a monument and was placed at the hospital. This led to creating a picture book about that day with the title I Will Never Forget That Day.
今日はこれを使ってお話したいと思います。
Today, I would like to talk using this picture book.
では、当時のことを振り返ってみます。戦争が厳しくなりました。元気な人はみんな兵隊に取られて、工場や会社で働く人が足りなくなりました。
I would like to look back on those days. The war situation had become worse day by day, and all healthy men were drafted. So there were few young people left to do the work in factories and farms.
国は法律を作って、中学生から勉強をやめて大人の作業をするように命令しました。
Then the central government had launched a new law and ordered middle school students stop studying and help adults.
広島市でも3年生以上は兵器を作る軍事工場へ動員されました。
In Hiroshima, the ninth graders aged 15 and above were mobilized to make weapons.
中学1、2年生と子どもたち、12、3歳か13、14、15歳の子どもたちは建物疎開の作業に動員されました。
In total, 8,200 of 7th and 8th graders aged 13 and 14 were mobilized to demolish buildings.
建物疎開というのは空襲に備えて、たくさんの家を壊して空き地を作る、防火地帯を作る作業です。
Building demolition means destroying a lot of houses and buildings to make a vacant lot and creating a fire break in preparation for air raids.
一時電車の12、3歳から14、15歳の子どもたちは暑い夏日の下で一生懸命大人の作業を手伝いました。8,200 人の子どもたちが手伝って、6,300 人の子どもたちが原子爆弾で亡くなりました。
On that morning, boys and girls between age 12 and 15 were working outdoors in the summer heat. Then more than 6,300 out of the 8,200 were killed by the atomic bomb.
私の学校にはミシンがたくさん運ばれてきて、私たちは兵隊のシャツを縫うことになりました。
In previous years, a lot of sewing machines were brought to my school, and our school became a factory for soldiers' uniforms.
ペンを持つことはありません。毎日、朝礼の後、薙刀の稽古がありました。
No studies, no pens. Instead, every morning we practiced with a Japanese halberd.
部屋がいっぱいになったので、今度は運動場で竹の先を尖らして竹槍というのを持って、中段の構え、突きという人を刺す動作をしました。訓練をしました。
We practiced with the bamboo spear and practiced the sticking people.
今頃考えるとナンセンスだと思います。竹の棒切れで。拳銃を持った兵隊と戦えるはずはないのにと思いますが、軍国主義の時代でしたから、私たちは一生懸命訓練しました。
Now I know it was totally nonsense. A girl cannot fight with a bamboo stick against bullets. But at that time, Japan was in the middle of the war, so we practiced very, very hard.
8月3日、原爆の落ちた日、両親は朝早く飛行場を作る作業に動員されて出て行きました。
In the early morning of August 6th, my parents went to work to build an airfield.
家には3歳の住み子の子供が疎開してきていましたので、私はその子の面倒を見るために学校を休んでおりました。
I was absent from school because I had to take care of my three-year-old nephew who had been evacuated from central Hiroshima city.
朝ごはんをあげようとした時でした。静かな突然、ダーン、カーンというすごい爆発音がして、家に爆弾が落ちたと思いました。裸足で外へ飛び出しました。
When I was trying to give him breakfast, suddenly I heard a terrible explosion, sounded like dog gun, and I was surprised and went out.
家の外に出てみると何も変わったことがありません。おかしいなと思っていると、西の南の空から雲がわーっと湧き上がるのが見えました。テレビも何もありませんから、何が起きたのか分かりませんでした。
But it seemed nothing happened around my house. While wandering and standing in the garden, I saw a big cloud rising over the mountain. But at that time, there were no TV, so I didn't understand what had happened over there.
私の家の前は鉄道が通っていて、汽車が蒸気機関車が走っていましたが、その日は朝から汽車が動きません。
There was a railroad running in front of my house, but on that day, no locomotive ran from the city.
夕方動き始めた汽車が広島からたくさんの怪我をした人、田舎の駅に連れて帰りました。そうして広島が爆弾で全滅したという話が伝わり、大騒ぎになりました。
In the evening, a train arrived at the village station carrying many, many injured people from Hiroshima. They told us that a large bomb dropped on the city, and that single bomb had totally wiped out the big city of Hiroshima.
次の日、姉を探して広島の町へ出てきました。広島の駅は被爆しているので、途中の矢賀という駅におりました。
The next day, my mother and I got on the first train and headed for Hiroshima City in search of my sisters. Because Hiroshima Station was destroyed, we were told to get off at Yaga Station.
プラットホームに降りた途端にものすごい悪臭がしていました。目や鼻が刺すようでした。そして目を開けてびっくりしました。広島の街がきれいに消えてなくなって、たくさんの家がなくなっているんです。
As soon as we got off the train, we were struck by an awful stench. It stung our eyes and noses. When I finally opened my eyes, I was shocked. The city of Hiroshima that had existed there until yesterday had completely disappeared.
ただただ広い焼け野原の向こうにいつも見ることのできない瀬戸内海に浮かぶ二の島が鮮やかな緑だったことだけは印象に残っています。
Only vast burned fields were there. The thing I was impressed was the vivid green color of Ninoshima Island beyond the burned field, which we couldn't usually see.
この写真がその時私が見た広島の状態です。被爆直後の状態です。
This photo shows Hiroshima that I saw on that day.
私たちは広島に向かいます。私たちが向かう反対側は、被爆して大けがをした人たちが少しでも郊外に逃れて行こうとして、長い長い行列がついて、どうしたんでしょう、これ。長い行列がついておりました。その人たちを見ると、髪がチリリリに焼けて、顔は腫れて、着物は焼け焦げて半分裸でした。
We walked into the city. On the other side of the road, however,There was a long line of people fleeing, people with severe injuries. Their hair was frizzled, their faces severely swollen, and they were half naked and bleeding.
火傷した皮膚が肩から剥がれて、爪の先にぶら下がっている。それをボロ切れのようにぶら下げて、うつろな顔で歩いている姿は、私は自分と同じ人間とは思いませんでした。お化けのような気がして見ないようにして歩きました。
Their skin peeled away from burns on their shoulders and arms and hung down from their fingertips like old rags. They walked slowly and slowly holding their arms up in front. I couldn't think they were people like me and I felt bad and scared like I was watching ghosts.So I tried not to see them and walked away.
ようやく長く歩いて広島市内に入りました。市内にはたくさん死体が転がって、足の踏み場がないようなところがありました。
At last we reached Hiroshima City. In the city, the roads were so full of corpses that there was no place to step.
強い熱線を浴びて、爆風に飛ばされた人間の体は大きく膨らんで 男か女かも分かりません。目玉が流れてゼリーのようになっています。舌が飛び出して炭のようになっていました。内臓が流れて卵焼きのような色をしていました。怖くて怖くて泣きながらそのとこ母にすがって歩きました。
The bodies which were blown by a violent blast and exposed to strong heat rays had swollen to double or triple their size, and it was impossible to tell if they were men or women. Their eyeballs were flowing down like jelly. Their organs were hanging out of their ripped bellies and were the color of a fried egg. I was horrified and cried.
瓦礫の道を長くと、ようやく遠くに姉の緑が勤める赤十字が見えてきました。
After a long time walking along the road through the rubble, we finally reached Hiroshima Red Cross Hospital, where my second eldest sister working as a nurse.
病院も大変なことになっていました。玄関も廊下も血まみれの人がいっぱい転がって、痛いよ、痛いよ。苦しいよ、お水ください、助けてください。みんなが泣きわめく声が大きなうなり声になっておって足がすくむようでした。
The hospital was also like hell. People covered in blood were writhing on the concrete floor or everywhere and crying out, It hurts, help me, give me water.
あの日病院ではお医者さんたちや看護さんたちは51人になりました。人手が足りません。生き残った兵看護師さんに母が姉の名前を言いました。そしたら、滝川さんは二の島へ運ばれたから大丈夫ですよと言われました。
On that day, totally 51 doctors and nurses were killed in that hospital. But we were told by one nurse that my second eldest sister had been saved and taken to the hospital, another hospital.And she was all right.
私たちは邪魔になる、聞きたくても聞くことができません。急が大混雑の病院から外に出ました。外に出てまた私はハッとしました。玄関の横に大きな丸い花壇がありました。そこに少年の死体が無造作に材木のように積み重ねてありました。思わず近寄ってみました。
Anyway, we went out from the confusion.We went outside of the hospital. Then I was frightened. The dead bodies of students my age had been piled in the round flower beds.
建物を壊す作業していて放射線にやられたんだと思います。
Maybe they were exposed to radiation while demolishing buildings.
住み込み姉を探すためにまた橋を渡りました。橋の上から川を見ると満潮の川を見した。いっぱい浮かんで、ゆらりと水に揺れておりました。波揺れ。
Then we crossed the bridge again to look for my other sister. From the bridge, a tremendous amount of bodies was floating in the river at high tide.
6日にほのほに言われて、海に降りた人は引き潮でみんな、川に降りた人は引き潮で海に流されました。また満潮でこの川へ帰ってきます。次の日また引き潮で海に。また満潮で当分死体は海と川を行ったり来たりしました。
Most people who were caught by the flames and dove into the river died in vain on that day. Their bodies were washed away by the ebb tide, then pushed back from the sea on the high tide. They were washed away and pushed back for a while.
橋を渡ると、これは6日の日の写真です。煙が出ているところは広島市内です。橋を渡ったこっちは川が防波堤になる防火帯になったんでしょうね。距離もあるし、火事になっておりませんでした。家は壊れておりました。
This is a picture taken on that day. My sister's house was hit by the blast, but had escaped the fire because the river worked as a fire break.
姉の家も壊れていましたが、姉や年寄りが生きていたので母が泣いて喜びました。
My sister's house was broken, but they were alive. My mother rejoiced and cried.
帰り道、今度は電車を通りを通って帰りましたが、町の中は死体がゴロゴロ転がって、馬も転がっています。たくさんの死体が転がっていました。
On the way back, there were a lot of bodies, even the horse bodies, lying around the city.
爆心地近くには電車がいっぱい軌道を外れています。真っ黒く煙、中は空っぽになっていました。
In the area close to the epicenter, many charred streetcars had derailed.
一台の電車を何気なく見ると、黒いものがぶら下がって、炭のようなものがたくさんぶら下がっているんです。よく見ると、それは人間が釣り革を持った腕が体から取れて、炭の棒になっているんです。これもぎょっとしました。
I happened to look up. I saw black things hanging down in the car. When I looked more closely, I noticed that it was charred arms. Those arms were still holding onto the straps, but had become sticks of coal. I was horrified.
8階建ての福屋の建物で帰ってきました。コンクリートの外壁だけ残して、中は真っ黒に焼けておりました。
When we reached Fukuya Department Store, the inside of the 8-story building was burnt black, with only the external walls remaining.
その周りの道路には死体や怪我した人がいっぱいな寝かされているんです。
Many injured people and dead bodies were lying on the nearby road.
建物の片方に兵隊さんがたくさんうずくまっているのを見ました。行きたい台です。
There were also many soldiers crouching down there. They are almost dying.
私はいつまでも不思議に思いました。あの兵隊さんたちは怪我もしてない、やけどもしてないのに、どうしてあんなに息が切れられる、息が死なれてしまったんだろうか。と、不思議でしたが、今考えたら、あれは放射線のせいだったんでしょうね。
Although they did not have any burns nor injuries, their faces were ashen. I had always wondered about that. And a long time after, however, I learned that it was due to radiation.
放射能には色もありません。形もありません。匂いもありません。でも、それを一旦体に浴びると、人間の体の中深く浸透して、造血機能や染色体や遺伝子やみんな壊してしまい、人間は生きていくことができません。
Radiation has no color, no shape, nor odor. But once we are exposed to it, it penetrates deep into the body, destroying genes, chromosomes, and blood functions. Thus, humans cannot survive it.
私たちは一日中あまりむごたらしい人の姿を見て、おしまいで、はじめは涙が出ましたが、おしまいにはもう平気になってしまって、心が麻痺したんでしょう。福屋からはどうして家に帰った記憶がありません。
I had seen so many cruel deaths and injuries all day that my heart became paralyzed. And I lost my memory of what happened after Fukuya Department Store.
家に帰ってからのことは覚えています。
夜の闇
が怖くてたまりませんでした。死体がいっぱい転がっているのを錯覚して、当分夜の闇を怯えました。
For a while, I was scared of the dark, since there was only one lamp at night. When I went to other rooms, I imagined that many corpses were lying there.
3日後に助け出されて帰った隣の仲良しの文子ちゃんが亡くなりました。彼女は全身にガラスが刺さって探し出されて連れて帰られたんですが、医者もありません、薬もありません、そして氷もありません。みんなにお別れをちゃんと言って亡くなりました。
Fumiko, a girl in my neighborhood who was found 3 days after a bomb, died. All over her body was pierced by pieces of broken glass and covered with blood. Although she was able to come home, there was no doctor, no medicine, no water, no ice. Even with high fever, she managed to say goodbye to everyone and passed away.
上のお姉さんが赤ちゃんを連れてきました。でも赤ちゃんも弱っていて横に寝かせることができません。息苦しがるので、夜も昼も姉が抱っこしておりましたが、その子の膝の上で亡くなりました。
Sumiko, the elder sister, came home with her baby, but that baby was weakened because she couldn't breathe well when lying on the futon mattress. My sister always held her in her arms, but suddenly, She died in her mother's arms.
その頃から姉の髪の毛も抜け始めたり、歯茎からちぎれたりするようになりました。私も全身に体が出たとこ、頭も切れ物が出て、長い間苦しみました。
Shortly after, my sister's hair began to fall out, and her gums started to bleed. I had a rash all over my body, and it was annoying for a long time.
その頃、家の近くには被爆した人がいっぱい身を寄せておりました。学校も被爆者の収容所になりました。毎日5人も6人も人が死にます。毎日火葬場の煙が立ちました。村の人たちは交代で出て死体を焼きました。
At that time, in my neighborhood, many people who suffered from the A-bomb came back, and even schools became a place to stay for evacuees. Someone died every day, and I saw the smoke from the cremations every day.
たった一発の原子爆弾は、8月から12月までに14万人の人、命を奪いました。
By December 1945, about 140,000 people had died from a single bomb.
あれから75年経ちました。私は子供たちに戦争で行った友達のことをお話ししています。あの頃はお腹いっぱいご飯が食べれませんでした。お菓子も果物もありませんでした。
75 years have passed since then. Now, I have been talking to students who visit the Peace Memorial Park about my friends who were killed by the war. At that time, there was not enough food. We were always hungry. No cakes, nor fruits. No TVs.
何にも楽しいことがないのに、一生懸命10代で死んだ友達のことを知ってほしいんです。お母さん、お腹いっぱいご飯が食べたいよ。
I want to let you know that there were no friends who there were my friends who died while working hard for the country without feeling any joy. I want to eat a lot.
学校行って勉強したい。本が読みたい。
I want to study. I want to play sports.
お母さんに会いたい。
Oh, I want to see my mom.
少年の声が聞こえます。
I still hear their voices.
この写真はあの日亡くなった広島第二中学の1年生の写真です。写真は何にも言いませんが、訴えていると思います。
This is a portrait of the students who died during building demolition on that day. The portrait says nothing, but it appeals to us.
僕たちにはたくさん夢がありました。たくさんの希望がありました。でもそれを何一つ叶えることなく、一瞬の放射線で虫けらのように死んでしまいました。
We had a lot of dreams, we had a lot of hope, but without fulfilling any of them, we were killed by radiation at the age of 12 or 13.
戦争さえなかったら、原爆に触らなかったら、僕たちにも素晴らしい人生があったはずです。
If it were not for the war, if it were not for the atomic bomb,We would have had long and wonderful lives. I can still hear their voices.
お話は変わりますが、9年前東日本大震災がありました。
Now let me change a topic. Now 9 years ago, a terrible earthquake struck eastern Japan.
福島の原子力発電所も爆発しました。それからというもの、日本は地震や津波や大洪水で自然災害で苦しんでおります。
Fukushima nuclear power plant exploded. Even after that, Japan had suffered from repeated natural disasters such as earthquakes, tsunamis, volcanic eruptions, and floods.
でも、自然災害は人間の力で防ぐことができません。
Natural disasters cannot be handled by human power.
ですけれども、核兵器は人間のこの手が作りました。この手が使えます。この手でおしまいにできる通りなんですが、なかなか難しいですね。
However, nuclear weapons were made by humans and used by humans. Thus, it should be possible to eliminate them by human hands, although it looks difficult.
世界中の人たちが英知を集めて、連帯してこの問題も解決してほしいと思います。
Thus, I strongly hope that people all over the world gather their wisdom, discuss seriously, and work together to solve this problem.
10年前、アメリカに1回がありました。ミズーリの大学に行きました。
10 years ago, I had the opportunity to go to the United States and I visited the University of Central Missouri.
トルマン大統領の出身地ですから、話が聞いてもらえるかと不安でしたが、若い人たちは一生懸命聞いてくれました。
At first, I was worried if people in the hometown of President Truman would listen to my talk. However, young people listened ardently.
広島のことは知りませんでした。許してください。核のこと勉強します。家に帰って伝えます。みんなそれぞれ率直に意見を言ってくれました。
Some gave me their candid opinion, like I didn't know about Hiroshima. I will let my friends about this.
私は言葉には人の心を動かす強い力があると思います。大切なこと、原爆の恐ろしさ、しっかりと言葉の力を信じて伝えなければいけないと思いました。
I believe words have power to move the heart of people.Thus, we must believe in the power of words and must pass on the horror of the atomic bomb to the next generation.
75年間草むきも生えないと言われた広島が見事に復興しました。
Hiroshima, which was said to have no plans for 75 years due to radiation, has been beautifully reconstructed.
人々が住んでいたこの地区も平和公園として蘇り、核兵器廃絶と世界平和の願いを発信し続けています。
The Nakajima district, where many people lived, has also been revived as a peaceful peace memorial park and continued to send our wishes for nuclear abolition.
世界中では内戦や北朝鮮の核開発などいろいろと嫌なことがあって、私たちの思いより逆の方向に行っているような気がするときがありますが、絶望からは何も生まれません。
All over the world, there are many conflicts still occurring, or there are the North Korea, nuclear weapons development issues. Like this, that it looks that the world is heading for the opposite way.
たとえ小さな声であっても、世界平和と核廃絶を打ち出し続けていれば、やがて大きな力になると信じて希望を持ちたいと思います。
However, I believe even a small voice for the abolition of nuclear weapons and a prayer for peace will become a great power if band together.
ちょっと抜かしますね。原子爆弾は一瞬で街を根こそぎ壊して罪のない多くの人の命を奪います。
The atomic bomb instantly and totally destroys a city, killing a large number of innocent people.
今の核兵器は長崎や広島に使われたものよりも何百万も力が強いと言います。
Today's nuclear weapons are said to be hundreds of times more powerful than those used in Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
誰かが間違ってボタンを押したら人類は破滅です。
If someone accidentally presses a button,Human beings will perish.
どうか武力を使わないで外交の力で世界が平和が保たれるように皆さん力を尽くしていただきたいと思います。
Please appeal to people around you and the generation after you so that they will start their actions to maintain world peace through discussions and diplomacy without using force.
広島や長崎のことを次の世代の人たちもお伝えいただき、周りの人たちや皆さんにお伝えいただきたいと思います。
Please hand down this memorial to the people around you about Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
これで話終わります。No more Hiroshima. No more Nagasaki. No more war. Thank you very much.
It was a great honor and opportunity for me to talk to you today. Thank you very much.
I gotta say, first of all, arigato gozaimasu, Ms. Kono-san. It's just a truly an amazing, just everything that you've gone through. Thank you so much for sharing your words, your wisdom. One question that I have personally is, where do you find the courage, the energy, the inspiration moving forward, like, She's unmuted.
90歳になります。だから私たちの友達は10代で死にました。こんなに長く生きさせてまで生きている者の務めとして、あの光景をこの目で見た者の務めとして、できるだけあの人たちの無念を伝えたいと思っております。
Very fortunately, I survived, but my friends, many of my friends died in the age of the teenagers. Many teenager friends died because of the A bomb. So I believe this is my mission to pass on the tragedy to the people around the world.As many as possible, as much as possible. And I believe this is my mission, and I'm trying very hard to today.
Well, thank you. You're doing a wonderful job. I mean, just to read off some of the comments from our audience, some mentioned thank you for the memories and sharing with us. What an incredibly emotional and courageous and generous recount of your memories. Thank you from Australia. They've learned so much from this presentation. It's just wonderful you created a book too. Do you have any words of wisdom for today's youth, for future generations moving forward? How can we assist you in your mission?
やっぱりありのままを率直に嘘じゃないことを一生懸命私は伝えております。見たことしかありません。それぞれみんな体験が違いますから、ああそういうことがあったか思うこともありますが、私は自分の体験したことしか話せないけれども、一生懸命子どもたちに伝えております。そしたら子どもたちが一生懸命答えてくれます。やっぱり自分では一生懸命伝うことしか不器用だからできません。すいません。
Yes, I believe the important thing is to tell the truth. I only talk about the truth, or the what I saw actually. I know there are many different people.Different survivors experience different things, but I only talk about my truth, and I talk very hard to the children. Then the young children have some reaction, some reply reaction to me, and I think the important thing is to make their best, make our best, make hard, do our best is most important, I think.
Thank you. We have a couple more questions from one person had a question about where can they buy your book?
The books areselling. I mean, the books are in the Hiroshima Peace Memorial Museum.
And
outside, there are no place to buy, unfortunately.
Okay.
Abroad.
So currently, it's not being sold online. That can be shipped any. Okay, got it. So just means we have to make a trip to Hiroshima when.
Hiroshima に旅行するでね。
ぜひ来てください。
Please come to Hiroshima.
Wonderful. Somebody else, thank you. A question from our audience. They just want to relay, thank you so much for sharing your testimony. You've lived a long life. Having survived an end of the world experience, what are your greatest joys in day-to-day life? Is there a spirituality guiding you forward? That was a question.
ぱり私は喜びなんですかね。なんでしょう。
幸せに感じられたこと。幸せに感じられたこと。
幸せに感じることは子供たちが3人、はい、主人が34歳で亡くなったもんですから、それから3人がまあちゃんと大学出て大きくなって成人してくれたことと、それからですね、アメリカ行って中学生の写真やら、ふみこちゃんの写真やら見て、アメリカの人たちにこう聞いてもらった時に、私なんか自分が責任果たしたような気がしました。トルーマンライブラリーも行って記帳してきましたけれども、やっぱりなんか人たちに代わって、ふみこちゃん、あなたここへ連れてきてあげましたよって、なんか自分で言いながらしたら、映像が笑ったような気がして、なんか幸せに思いました。
はい。One of the greatest joy for me was my three children and my grandchildren, because my husband unfortunately died when he was 34 years old, but my children are grown very successfully.And the other thing is, when I visited the United States and I showed my picture book to the many young Americans, and do you remember that Fumiko, my closest friend, unfortunately died of the atomic bomb, but by showing her picture, I said in my mind, Fumiko, now we are in America, I'm with you in America, andI thought I was able to take my responsibility, and I thought Fumiko smiled by looking the picture book. So that was a big joy for me.
Yeah, that's really beautiful. We have one of our friends from Michiko from the Nagasaki Foundation for the Promotion of Peace in Nagasaki. She actually wrote it in the chat in both Japanese and English. So, but I'll read it out loud for the audience who's on the live stream. Michiko-san mentioned, as well as the Hiroshima struggle, Nagasaki as well as Hiroshima struggle to hand over the storytelling by young generations. What do you think is the biggest challenge in handing over your story? What kind of advice can you give us?
やっぱり一番根底には核兵器の廃絶を言って、自分が体験したことを、嘘じゃないことを話すのが一番大事。なんか嘘を聞く時があるんです、時々ね、なんか 嘘じゃないかなと思うようなことがあるから、そういうことはいけないと思います。自分が体験したことを次の世代の人たちに伝えるのはなかなか難しいですね。生活様式が違ってきて、私が孫に問いた、人を運ぶのに担架がないから問いたで運びましたって言ったら、飛ばんって言うんですよね。だからそういう時代の生活様式が違っていることもやっぱり理解してもらわなきゃいけないし、全部今の時代の死体を草履を履いて死体の中をまたいで歩いたのよって言っても、なぜ長靴履かないんですかって今の子どもたちは言いますし、やっぱりああいう生活の仕方が理解してもらうのにすごく難しいと思います。だけどやっぱり実物を見せたりして、本当のことを、とにかく本当のことを言うべきだと私は思っております。そして若い人にしっかり伝承してもらいたいと思っています。
I think the most important thing is to tell the truth, not to tell a lie. Because there are many different stories, and I sometimes it looks not a truth. I feel from the other people's testimony or the story, because the lifestyle has become different from all the time. So sometimes it's difficult to inform the situation, we experienced. For example, that somebody said they conveyed the dead bodies by the stretchers, the people, young people, don't know about that. What kind of thing that stretcher is at that time, the portable stretchers. Or another example is, I walked with the slippers over the rubbles. Young people said, why didn't you put on the long boots? That kind of thing. So it is difficult for young people to imagine that situation. But I believe the important thing is we should talk about the truth, although it is difficult, and try to convey our experience, real experience, to younger people.
I just have to say thank you so much. This concludes our questions and really concludes our event today, but I just have a few words today. I just want to say arigato gozaimasu, Ms. Kono-san, for sharing your story of resilience with us today, to learn more about your experience and your family. I am truly humbled by your journey as a peace builder and for providing us with this opportunity to relive that fateful day. I appreciate being able to connect with you to learn about your resiliency during such unprecedented times, and just your spirit, your soul, just moving forward is very inspirational. Your story definitely provides a lot of hope and vision as we ourselves look to overcome challenges in our own lives as peace builders today. Arigato gozaimasu to Ms. Hitomi Sato-san and the Hiroshima Peace Memorial Museum for your partnership in allowing us to make this event a reality. And last but not least, thank you to all for joining today's webinar. We deeply appreciate your interest and support in joining us to learn about resiliency during unprecedented times through our beginning and end of the bomb talk story series.